Everybody, my name is Matthew Fallon, and your camp director, Nicole, invited me to be able to perform and show you some magic here tonight via this video. This goes out to all of Camp Korey, all you magical and super strong campers and families. This is for you. I wore my Superman shirt just for you. I know it's a silly dad joke, but I'm feeling really happy for you guys, and I wanted to give you a symbol of strength, which I'm not a big guy, but I got the Superman shirt on. I'm gonna show you some really fun magic, and I hope you really enjoy this.
Well, who am I? Well, my name is Matthew Fallon, and that is Mistia with me right there, my wife, and together we created Mastering the Mystery, a large full stage illusion, magic, illusion, and aerial arts show. My wife is an aerial artist. I am not. I'm the illusionist. And together we created this amazing show, and we feel so fortunate to tour the world, primarily on large cruise lines, big, beautiful stages and theaters like that one right there. These things are huge performing arts centers on board ships. I was 14 years of age when I became a professional magician. Magic was always a dream of mine, especially the magicians of the past, Harry Houdini, Charles Carter, Howard Thurston. These were inspirations for me growing up, and I look forward to sharing some magic with you here today. I'm excited as well to teach you a piece of magic that you could do and carry in your pocket, have with you all the time, so you too can share joy and amazement with all those around you. Right on. So sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy this.
It's time to learn a piece of magic right now. And this is actually one of my favorite pieces of magic. It is super easy to do, very quick, very handy, and all you need is a rubber band. In this case, we're gonna use two, but I'll get to the second one in a moment. But let's start with a blue rubber band. I'm gonna put the rubber band around my pointer finger and my middle finger. And if I wrap it around those fingers, watch real carefully. Snap my fingers. It hops to my pinky and my ring finger. Did you see it? Let's do it again. But this time, let's go back the other direction. Watch. Rubber band wrapped around my ring finger and my pinky finger. Here we go. Watch. Boom. Did you see it? Now, Let's bring in the second rubber band. It's a brown one. I'm gonna put it around my ring finger and my pinky finger. The blue one is around my index finger and my middle finger. Remember which one's where. Remember, the blue here, the brown one here. Now, watch real carefully. Here we go. Do you see it? Let's see if we can go back the other way. Here we go. The brown one, pointer finger and middle finger. The blue one, ring finger and pinky. Watch. One, two, three. Boom. And they jump yet again. Now, let's add one last bit of super impossibility to this effect. Okay, so remember when I said we're going to add one more element of super impossibility to our rubber band effect? Our jumping rubber band effect, here it goes. In case you're thinking that maybe the rubber bands are leaping up over my fingers and flying through the air at a rapid pace and jumping to the other pair, we're going to add that super other element of impossibility right now. It's going to use a third rubber band, and it looks like this. It could really be anyone, any kind of rubber band, but here it is. I'm going to take this rubber band, and I'm going to put it around that finger. Twist it, middle finger. Twist it, ring finger. Twist it, pinky. Look at that, real close. My fingers are locked together. Now, there's no way that the blue one or the brown one could leap up and over while this is here because these are locked. So let's try it. Remember, the blue one and the brown one are both in play. Here we go. The blue one, pointer finger and middle. The brown one, pinky and ring finger, locked together in their spots with that third rubber band, the super element of impossibility. Watch. Did you see it? It happened so fast. The brown one actually made it to the middle and pointer finger, and the blue one actually made it to the ring finger and the pinky. Now, to end this, let's go back the other way. Here we go. Going back to where we were. Now, remember, right now, the brown is on the middle and the pointer. The blue is on the ring finger and the pinky. Watch real carefully. Don't blink. One, two, three. Do you see it? Actually locked. Passed through my fingers. It's the only way I think this effect can work. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, that is the jumping rubber band effect. Now, here comes the secret. Ready? Here it is. The secret to the jumping rubber band effect. Now, you'll remember, we started with just one blue rubber band jumping back and forth from these two to these two and back again. And then we added a second rubber band, the brown one, which then also jumped from these two to these two. Both of these go back and forth, seemingly impossible. And then we added the element of impossibility, a third rubber band, seemingly locking my hand together, my fingers rather, together. How did these actually jump? Here's the secret. You know, magic, I always say when I teach it, is 90% performance, 10% secret or method. What that means is if you had a piece of, or rather a pie of pizza, a big pizza, 10 pieces, 9 of those pieces would be all about the presentation, the performance. 1 piece would be about the secret. Now, that's not to say the secret is less important than the performance. Oh, no. What that does mean is that when you learn the secret of any magic effect, be it a small one that can fit in your hands and do in your fingertips and close up like this, or a largest of stage illusions, the secret, usually when you learn it, it's like, oh my gosh, that's all that is? because the performance is what stays in the audience's mind, in their hearts, and gives that moment of impossibility. So here's the secret. Okay, so let's start with our blue one. We can see it the best. You can use literally any rubber bands you like. The best ones I like, honestly, are the ones that you're gonna find when you buy some asparagus. You know what I mean? They're a little bit thicker, and they're not too big around. Of course, you could stretch them pretty big, but they're that perfect size. So here's our secret. Let's start with the blue one. It's pretty easy to see, like I said. We're gonna put it around our pinky and our ring finger to start with. Now let me show you backstage. Here's what happens when my hand was facing toward me and I simply closed my hand around and made it jump. Here's what happens backstage. Again, start with the rubber band around your middle finger and your pinky. I'm sorry, your ring finger and your pinky. You're gonna see your palm like this, okay? You're gonna pull the rubber band out like that. Close all four fingers into the band and gently let it sit. Very easy. From the audience's point of view, your point of view, that's what you see. That's what they see. Right around there. So everything looks absolutely okay from the front. Watch this. When I open my fingers, here's the backstage view again. It jumps to the middle and pointer. Let's do it once again, completely backstage view for you. So pretend this is your palm, your rubber band, your pointer, and your middle finger. You pull the band out, drop all four fingers in, let the band gently rest across the fingernails or the first knuckle of the fingers. Snap the fingers. Remember, presentation is everything. Snap the fingers, say the magic word, open up, and it happens all by itself. It jumped to the pinky and to the ring finger. Pretty cool, right? Okay, so if we were to add the second rubber band, in this case, I had a brown one. Take a look. I'm gonna put it right there around my pointer and my middle. Makes no difference. All we're gonna do is pull out both rubber bands, but how do you put your fingers in between both at the same time? Here's how. You see real closely, when I pull one out and I pull one out, I get a center circle, don't I? Right there. When I cross them, one crosses over the other, like that, and I get a center circle. My fingers go in there, right there. From the front, this is what the audience sees. You, this is what you see. When you snap your fingers, say the magic word, pop, they swap places. A seemingly impossible solid through solid magic effect. And this is famous among magicians for years and years and years, centuries, from close up like this all the way up to stage magic, and even bigger, grand illusion we call it. So let's add the last element, the element of impossibility. That was just a third rubber band. Again, it could be anyone you like. But all I did, and I'll show you your view now again, was I put it around one finger, and I gave it a twist, and I put it on the other finger, and I twisted it again. Now that finger, and I twisted it again, and then this finger. So real close, you could see what I got. My four fingers are kind of locked together by this rubber band. To the audience's perception, their view of this, it seems impossible now that these rubber bands could come off the fingertips, fly through the air, and back onto the other pair of fingers. So how do you do it in this step? Same way. With two rubber bands, you simply cross one over the other, forming that middle hole. Drop all four fingers into there. Let the bands rest across the first knuckles right there. Say the magic words. Well, first, let's show you what the audience will see from this angle. Remember, this is what they see. This is what you'll see. You say the magic words, snap your fingers, make the magic happen, pop, and boom, it still happens. Isn't that cool? I love it. You know, guys and gals, self-working magic is what this category of magic is. Self-working. You have to do a little bit of secret. Yeah, you bet. But for the most part, this thing happens all by itself. And so therefore, you can play it up. Presentation. Magic. Absolutely magic. So in this case, they jump back and forth under impossible conditions. I sure hope you enjoy it. This was the jumping rubber band. Hey, Camp Korey. I'd like to show you this one piece of magic, a simple spool of sewing thread. I want to thank you for having me for this week's theme. I'm truly, truly honored. I'm humbled. You have an amazing organization. My goodness. You have to read a little bit about it. I hadn't heard about it. I live in Colorado, Colorado Springs. I'm born and raised in San Francisco. So I hadn't had the opportunity to learn about Camp Korey. And my goodness, what an amazing, amazing facility, group of people, organization it is. It's awesome. So thank you for having me to be able to entertain you for a little bit and engage you and teach you. And I hope you've enjoyed this. This is one of my favorite pieces of magic, utilizing a single spool of sewing thread. Piece. Many people wonder how the heck did I become a magician? I was a young kiddo and stubbornly I said, I have a dream. Make that dream happen. Dream of being a magician. And I soon, kind of in my early teens, realized I better make that dream into a goal. I better attach a deadline to that dream because a dream without a deadline simply remains a dream. I needed a goal, a lot of determination, never saying no to my laziness, constant willpower, never taking no for an answer, and a lot of love, a lot of love. I love what you do, love people, and I mean that sincerely. It was about 12, maybe 13 years ago that I decided to make a life mission for myself, a mission statement. That mission statement was to elevate the energy in a room. I love to feel grateful to have the opportunity to make people happy, to take them away for a little bit, to help them feel like the impossible is possible, to help them feel included, strengthened, empowered. You know, individually, back to the story of childhood, a dream, a goal, a lot of determination, a lot of love, strength, courage, all of the above are great individual qualities. But together, I really think that they're a recipe. To make it real sticky. Stick right on there. That's right. I feel it's a recipe for making almost anything possible. See that? Solid piece of strength, once again. One of my favorite pieces. Thank you for indulging me, Camp Korey. Thanks for having me. Again, I'm honored to be a part of your weekly theme. Thank you, Nicole, for inviting me to do so. And Camp Korey, I am blown away. Again, as I've read more about your organization, about the camp, the strength, the determination, the courage, an amazing, amazing organization you have. So God bless you all. Be well. May this all blow past us quickly, at least to a point that we can get some hugs back in again. I'm sure missing my hugs. I'm sure you all are as well. Camp Korey, be well. God bless. Take good care. Thanks again for having me. I'm Matthew Fallon. Bye-bye.